that right there, that tail, I think I might be able to move it along. It's almost a two-man job, man.
Yeah.
Let me see something. You're blocking the camera. This is slippery. Thing about it is you gotta just go right along the both sides of the center here. And just get this fillet that slab off. Takes a little doing, but I think you get around to it without cutting the finger. Always the nastiest part, but it's got to be done, right? A lot of people don't want to take the time to do this. They think it's too hard. Well, as you see, it wasn't that difficult at all, was it? You come out with a lot of meat. This 13-pound buffalo fish will probably yield close to half of its body weight. by keeping this large fillet. Now, the trick is to cook the fillet and see if we can cook down the bones so that they're edible. I'm going to try to remove all of the gray lining inside the stomach as much as you can. Yeah, you might want dig in there and remove it. It's part of survival. I bet if there wasn't more, I bet if you had to eat, a lot of people would learn how to do this real quick. I've seen people throw these things away on the side, or just go for the heck of it, just go and harpoon them, or they don't even know it. This is a buffalo fish, it's not a carp. There's a difference. A lot of people confuse the two. I tell you what, when you land a carp on your hook, you're in for the fight of your life. Boy, I tell you what, that is a fight. Now these buffalo fish, they're not that hard to catch once you got them hooked. They are hard to hook, but they're not hard to catch if you just take your time, let them play out, let them get tired. They get tired pretty quickly. Those German carp, look out, boy. You gotta work with them. Better have some good line too. Okay, so we're ready to cut these into ribs. See the ribs here? All right, see how it's coming apart from the backbone?